Thanks, Sean. It's always great to be back around your neck of the woods. And thanks for being such an outstanding voice for the people of Nova Scotia and for all Canadians as our housing minister. Je suis très heureux d'être ici avec d'autres membres de notre équipe de la Nouvelle-Écosse, Cody, Darren et Lena aussi. But I'm really happy to be here at the Truro campus of the Nova Scotia Community College. I just had a chance to meet some of the amazing people who work in healthcare, who are joining us here today on either side. Thank you for being here today to talk with us about what we're doing to make healthcare more accessible for everyone. We're focused on fairness for every generation, which means, among other things, making housing more affordable to empower younger generations like millennials and Gen Z. It means creating the good jobs of tomorrow while fighting climate change today. And it also means improving our healthcare system, making sure everyone has access to the care they need, and protecting the integrity of universal healthcare in Canada by standing up to those who want to privatize it. First off, we're investing $200 billion to help provinces, territories, and Indigenous partners improve healthcare results and outcomes for Canadians. These investments will, among other things, make it possible to train more doctors and nurses, reduce hospital wait times and backlogs, and most importantly, improve access to primary care and to mental health services. On top of this, we're also launching the first phase of a national pharmacare plan by making diabetes medications free and by making contraception medications and devices free. L'insuline peut coûter jusqu'à $1,700 par année. Un Canadien sur quatre atteint de diabète ne dit pas suivre son plan de traitement parce que les prix sont trop élevés. Alors, on va changer ça. We're also making contraceptive medication and devices free. Being pro-choice means we believe that women should be free to choose whether, when, and how they plan a family. Right now, only a fraction of Canadian women are eligible for prescription birth control at low or no cost through a public drug plan. Les contraceptifs oraux coûtent environ $300 par année. Et les stérilets coûtent jusqu'à $500 chacun. Mais dorénavant, les contraceptifs sur ordonnance vont être gratuits pour les Canadiens. Coverage for contraceptives will mean that millions of Canadians will have better access to contraception and reproductive autonomy. This will help improve family planning, reproductive rights, and fundamentally, equity. Quand on dit qu'on est en train d'améliorer l'accès aux soins de santé pour les Canadiens, ça inclut aussi les soins dentaires. L'automne dernier, on a lancé notre plan pour aider les gens qui n'ont pas d'assurance pour aller chez le dentiste. Le plan couvre, entre autres, les nettoyages, les plombages, les radiographies et les prothèses dentaires. Over 2 million Canadian seniors have already signed up for our dental program, and in the 3 weeks since May 1st, 100,000 seniors have been able to receive dental care. This is real progress. Progress on care, progress on affordability. Bringing down the cost of medications and dental care is making life more affordable for Canadians. These measures are based on the idea that everyone in this country should have access to the care they need, no matter where they live or how much money they have in their bank account.